Hello, British friends. Welcome to my August TBR. In this video, I will first of all talk about the books that I plan to read for my yearly TBR goals. And then I will talk about the books that I plan to read for the readathon that I'm planning to participate in August, which is Garb August. I only have one body read planned for August, which is Giovanni's Room by James Baldwin. I plan to body read this book with Nikki at Red Dot Reads. I really do love the body reading experience with her, and I cannot wait to read this book with her. This will be my first James Baldwin book, so I'm extra curious about this book. As for my real life book club, I have one book that I certainly need to read, which is the book that I chose for the book club, which is Before the Coffee Gets Cold by Toshikazu Kawaguchi. I chose this book because I've heard actually mixed things about the book, and I also love the concept of time travel, so I guess this will be a very good book for the book club discussion. For my online book clubs, I'm planning to read three books if I can. First one is the book for the Fear of Missing Out book club, which is The Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. I have previously read Circe by this author and really, really liked it. So I'm very eager to read this one. For the Killer Reads book club, I will read The Double Identity by James McCain. I have previously seen the adaptation of this book, and I know that it is a good mystery book. So this is a book that I'm very excited as well. Lastly, for the Kindred Spirits book club, the book of the month is Green Sleeves by Eloise Jarvis McGraw. I have not heard of this book before I saw the list of the books, but when I searched the Goodreads, the readers says that they really, really loved this book, so I thought, why not give it a try. The August book for Books of Alfred Hitchcock is Under Capricorn, which was written in 1937 by Helen Simpson. This book was filmed as Under Capricorn, the same title, by Alfred Hitchcock. And I have to admit, I do not remember much about the adaptation, although I saw it before. So this will be a book which is very likely to surprise me. For my series cup, I am going to read the third book in the Lady Janice series, written by Cynthia Hand, Brody Ashton, and Jodie Meadows, which is My Calamity Jane. I'm really enjoying this young adult series, and very interestingly, although I'm not a big fan of humor in books, I'm loving the quite raw humor in these books. As for my physical books TBR class, like I mentioned in my media goal video, I have revised the goal of reading all of the 12 books. But like I said in that video, I will continue choosing a book a month in order to give an alternative to the total of 12 books that I will read from my bookshelf. And the book is Aşk Bunamaz by Nalan Nahari. My mother read this book and said that it was an emotional read about Alzheimer's. I think this will be a good option, considering that I will read lighter books for Garb August. The first yearly challenge that I'm doing is Golden Girls Reading Challenge, and the prompt for August is True Crime. I specifically chose this audiobook for this prompt exactly 2 months ago. which is Malaysian Murders and Mysteries by Andrew Sagayam and Martin Wendezagan. This is a collection of case studies about the murders that happened in Malaysia. And I thought this would be a good addition to my other yearly reading challenge, which is Reading Around the World Challenge. For my series about series challenge, although I couldn't start the series in July like I planned to, I will progress in Crazy Rich Asians series by Kevin Kwan. And I will also progress in my goal of finishing the series with less than 3 books left by reading the third book in My Lady Jane's series, My Calamity Jane. The readathon that I plan to participate is Garbogus, like I mentioned before. This readathon was created by Criminally last year, and because I was heavily involved with my Berna's Bookish Bingo for that month last year, I couldn't participate it. But I thought it was a very very fun readathon, and I've said that if they do it this year, I will certainly participate. In Garbogust, there is a bingo board, but I will do the weekly prompts. In the first week of August, which is August 1st to 6th, we would either read a category romance or man's adventure book. And I chose to read a category romance, of course, but this is a novella set in the Ottoman Empire, Turkey, my country, which is called Innocent in the Harem by Michelle Willingham. This was first published by Mills & Boon Historical Andan. And I also plan to do a Turkish shelf video about this novella, which seems to be an erotica, which will probably be a very fun video for me, as well as a fun video for Garbogust. The second week in Garbogust is Paper Bags from Hell or Vintage Smut. The second week is from 7th to 13th of August. I've decided to choose not Smut this time, but a paperback containing the word Hell, and I think it fits the category as well. Which is The Hellbound Heart by Clive Barker, published in 1991. And it is a part of Hellraiser series. I actually thought of this book when Kate's novel Adventures talked about the book in her channel. And I thought that it would be a very good addition to my Garbogus TBR. For the third week, the novelizations or books by famous people, novelizations of TV series or movies, it means. And the third week is from 14th to 20th of August. And I have the book that I reserved especially for Garbogus, which is Big Damn Hero by James Lovegrove, which is a novelization of the sci-fi series Firefly, which was cancelled after a season, but sort of became a cult TV series with very devoted fans. I'm not as devoted as they are, but I thought the series was very fun. Fourth week, Anything Goes, Literally Anything, which will cover a span of 10 days. And I chose a longer book for that time period, which is the second book in Deceptions duology, A Tangled Web by Judith Michael. The first book in this duology, which was of course Deceptions, featured sex scenes. I had never read spicy scenes before because I was just 13. And as a teenager, it was very, very interesting to learn that such books did exist. So those are the books that I plan to read for August and the readathon Garbogust. Please comment down below. Have you read any of the books that I've mentioned in this video? And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose hell. Hell means cehennem in Turkish, and cehennem is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.